Hey, welcome KTM fans to the official kickoff of what is 30 years of Duke, celebrating 30 years of an iconic model in the KTM range. Location we've chosen, Almeria, Spain, to host 90 media from all over the world that get a chance to ride the KTM 390 Duke, KTM 990 Duke, as well as the beast, the KTM 1390 Super Duke R and Evo. Would have noticed a really interesting campaign name, and that is No Bullshit. Pretty interesting story, but it fits right into what the motorcycle really is. It's unapologetic, it's raw, it's naked from the ground up, and hence, you know, why use six words when one is enough? Hashtag No Bullshit.
Only KTM would launch a bike with the slogan No Bullshit. Only KTM would let us race around a car park in Malaga, and only KTM would let us do rolling burnout, screech tyres, and just ride like hooligans, generally. But all in perfect safety and with an amazing film crew to back it up.
All the time that the KTM media launch is something so exciting.
I don't think I need to do another wheelies for this whole year, because I'm wheelied out.
Fantastic couple of days. I really just couldn't be happier.
30 years of the Duke, I've enjoyed every second of it.
Three all-new bikes to ride.
Everything is better than previous model.
The 390 is superb handling, really great brakes, and really good new engine. So it's a like big bike in small package.
Really, really, really much fun.
I like the nimble handling.
I also like the new styling.
You feel more power now.
And just allow, you know, new riders and returning riders to just get into the sport of motorcycling. And what better way to do it with the Rowdy Dukes?
What a bike! Just sheer enjoyment. Think about this as a bike that is just sheer enjoyment and sheer fun to ride.
It was a very mature bike, very funny and enjoyable, also for motorbikers that start to ride.
If I had to pick one, I would probably go middle of the road with a 990, while the 990 has everything that I would need for sporty riding and for traveling.
Gosh, it makes it a bike that really can just do anything, and honestly, in a lot of ways, it makes it kind of that one bike that you can have for track days, commuting, street riding, just about anything.
It's got the right amount of power, it's got the right amount of chassis, you know, good trail numbers, good traction, it just worked pretty well all together.
I won it.
30 nights around the track, what an incredible weapon. It always was a weapon, now it's just
unbelievable.
Really, really impressive.
This bike is absolutely awesome.
The 1390 is still, for me, the best bike I've ever ridden. The technology put into the bikes, all the electronic packages, the new suspension settings, the engine, more torque, the shift cams, it worked perfectly. The bike now has more torque. It's a super fun bike to ride. It's not a bike for everyone, but everyone can enjoy it.
Spectacular.
It gives me a lot of goosebumps because no bullshit, and it shows no bullshit.
Tons of performance, you know, great braking, turns really nicely, looks angry as hell. It's like an end of the apocalypse kind of a motorcycle, that. Like, I love it, I think it's sick.
The attitude KTM has towards the Duke range is fantastic. It's why enthusiasts like me ride motorcycles, because we just want to feel alive, and you guys get that.
You need to get some Duke in your life, because it will make you the happiest person on earth. Man, when you start with that very first Duke, it's a tall thing to top. That bike was pretty iconic and has that kind of raw, wild edge that kind of defined KTM for the last three decades. What I love is that nothing's changed. We've got rider aids, we've got traction control, wheelie control, quick shifters, all this clever stuff. But right at the heart of them, they are still raw, rough, angry motorbikes that make you do bad things in bad places, and I love them.